He has been the main man of his league, but it took him 356 games to get to his first ever PBA Finals. On the other hand, Dorian Peña is a rookie in this league, but it only took him 4 games to get to this milestone. Berhel Meneses last won a championship back in 95 and is looking to bring back the glory in his game. Daniel De Bonzo has dominated this league since he arrived sa Bayern Superstars. Mark Caguioa is the new sensation. And Dynamite Danny is perhaps one of the best in the league today. Those are just some of the subplots in what is unraveling to be another classic. Kagaya na sinabi ng isang pamosong tao, walang kamakamag-anak, walang kaibigan. Huwag niyo silang subukan. This is the All-Filipino Finals. Maganda-maganda kami po sa inyo lahat mga kaibigan. Welcome sa Bayan ng Superstars for game number 1 ng All-Filipino Conference Best of 7 Series between the San Miguel Beermen and the Barangay Ginebra Kings. We have a magnificent crowd out here sa Big Dome, and again, this place is gonna be rocking. At kami po yung natutuwang makakasama kayo lahat. Ako po si Noli Yala, and today, makakasama ko sa panel two basketball, brilliant basketball minds. Of course, ang aming regular panelist, assistant team manager ng Red Bull, si Dr. J. Andy Howe, and somebody who knows these two teams very, very well. He should have been in Boracay today, but he's not. Coaching consultant, Ron Jacobs. Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening, Noli.
Good evening, Dr. J.
Good evening, Noli, and good evening, Ron.
Same here, Andy.
You know, this is just a magnificent setting, gentlemen, for what is turning out to be a dream matchup, Dr. J.
Well, you know, I feel that the match this series is really going to be a big one and a good one. I think a lot of people know that these two teams are sister teams, and they take for granted that it's not going to be great competition. I'm going to be the first one to say that this certainly is not true.
So, yeah, alam naman natin that these two teams always battle like there's never any tomorrow. And Ron, you know, these two teams had to struggle coming into the finals. And when you look at the road to the finals, you must wonder how these two teams just got here.
It was a difficult road for both teams. San Miguel was basically hurt. Siegel with a bad back, Roybitz with hepatitis, and the health of Freddie the Buddha's leg was in really worried the coaching staff. Of course, everybody knows the Ginebra story. Their backs were the wall. The two great games against Pure Foods, which was very, very fortunate. Everybody knows those two shots in the end. The great series with Shell. So maybe Ginebra has a little bit more momentum, but I think it's going to be a great series.
Uncle Jay, the numbers of this series will show that this is going to be indeed a great series. We know that these two teams not only thrive on their offense, but their defense has just been outstanding as well.
Well, I think San Miguel certainly has the advantage if we talk about defense. You know, they're a team that have big men. They can defend the post. They can defend the inside. Ginebra will have a problem there, I think, defending against the big men of San Miguel. But we also look at the numbers here, and we realize that, you know, here it's surprising because San Miguel has averaged more points compared to Ginebra, who is more of a running team. And you can see the big statistical advantage in the fast break points for Barangay Ginebra over San Miguel. It just shows that San Miguel, a very good half-court team, knows how to deliver when crunch time comes around.
You know, Ron, you know these two teams very well, especially the players who play in these two teams. There are two first-timers in the finals, one rookie and one veteran. Jun Limpot is making his first stint in the finals. It's been a long, long while. Mark Caguioa has parked your team in the semifinals, and he's making his first stint. How do you assess their performance coming into the finals?
Well, I think the pressure's off both players now. They made it to the finals, and when I was with Ginebra, we kept saying we got everything to gain and nothing to lose, and I assume that's what they're going out there to do. And that's how they played. I mean, they went out there and says, hey, we'll give it our best shot and see what happens.
Indeed, and Ginebra's making their first final since 1997. San Miguel looking for their first all-Filipino crown since 1994. San Miguel on the other hand, Dr. J, is brandishing two Dannys. They have carried the load for San Miguel, and they certainly will carry the load again.
Well, we know that the focus of their patterns are always with Danny Ildefonso at the post, or with Danny Siegel, whether he has an advantage at the post or if they are able to swing around the ball around. And we know also that Danny Siegel has been now one of their main factors as far as shooting three-point shots is concerned.
You look at the numbers of the two deadly Dannys, and they will combine for at least almost 40 points in this ball game. One last note here, Ron, the coaches, you know them very well. Alan and John will face each other for the first time.
They're totally different coaches. They're very good in X's O, but Alan is very emotional. John is very introverted, very calm.
And welcome back, mga kaibigan, sa jam-packed Araneta Coliseum for game number one of the Best of Seven Championship Series between San Miguel Beer and Barangay Ginebra Kings. Take a look at our QuickTight starting five, brought to you by QuickTight, the all-in-one glue technology by Loctite, and Dorian Peña making a start here, Dr. J. And that certainly is a surprise because Peña is making his first start of the season.
That's right. It really surprises me. It takes away Gamboa or Nick Velasco from starting for San Miguel. But let's see what he can do against Alex Crisano.
You know, one thing that surprised us, Ron, when you played Shell, when Barangay Ginebra played Shell, was the fact that for a while, as you take a first shot of the game by Olsen Rosella, we saw how the backcourt of Barangay Ginebra just dominated the backcourt of Shell.
Well, I think that's one of the reasons Peña's starting. I don't think Jong wants Peña in the game when Mark comes into the game. He's too quick, so when he goes to double Mark, or he has to rotate, he can't rotate. So they're not going to do that. So they know Mark will probably be doubled at the three-point line, and they don't want Peña in there rotating. He doesn't know the rotations, I know that. Plus, he's a little slow.
Anticipating the starting five unit of the other team and people off the bench.
Good try.
Super Vulcan Hill Tapal from Alex Crisano. 2-0 is our count. Meneses with a long distance shot, a little short. Peña with a big rebound. Hunger factor here, gentlemen. Obviously, both teams looking for something that they have not had in a long time. San Miguel, 7 years in the waiting. He never last won a all-Filipino championship back in 88. Ron?
Yes, but I think the hunger is about equal. I think what has to happen here is Ginebra has to stay in the game early. Let their emotions get, you know, even during the game, they're maybe a little too high right now, too emotional. They just need to stay in the game.
Dr. J, obviously these two teams are going to be evenly halved in the house. Nakita natin ang tao dito, halos kalahating kalahate. But again, the sixth man here, ang tao.
Well, it's not going to be a big factor, you know. I think it would be for a Ginebra team who does not have a lot of experience playing championship games, not for San Miguel.
Excellent point. There's the first shot of Valdivia. Tip in ni Crisano, wala. Ildefonso grabs the rebound. How do you see this, Dr. J, unfolding? Is this going to be a high-scoring series? Is it going to be a slow game? Are we looking at a running attack here?
Well, as I said, it's Ginebra that should be able to try to come up with a fast game and the half-court game going to San Miguel. I don't think any of the scores are going to be high.
I tend to agree with that.
As they say, you win championships to defense, Coach Ron.
I hope Ron doesn't mind, especially if you know that almost both of them exactly know how the other team plays. So it's hard to score over a team that knows how you play. No?
That's exactly right.
A tale of two coaches. You saw Alan Kedik, mga kaibigan, making his first ever finals as a head coach. The last time he was in a finals as a player was in a San Miguel Beer jersey. Jong Ochico, on the other hand, looking for his fifth crown, trying to go 100% batting average in the finals. Here's Siegel, Malakas.
There was an interesting play down there. Meneses posted up Abuda and they didn't double. That'd be a big decision making.
And another botched play here and loose ball foul will be called on Dorian Peña. Now both teams are shooting badly here. Case of jitters?
I think so.
Especially for Ginebra, I think they're taking their shots too far from the basket. They're not really getting to the basket. You know, the only score so far has been a three-point shot from Olsen.
And there's going to be a substitution already. I think Allen wants to match up now. He wants
Wilmer
against Peña. I think that's what he wants.
So Mandala, Narito Simineses up against Ildefonso. What a matchup here.
Well, there was a switch there.
Tira ni Meneses sa labas. No. Peña with the second board. Here's Rosella. Over 3 minutes gone by, and we still have 3 points only in the board. Oh, Super Vulcan Hill Tapal to Crisano, but no, there's a foul.
A great pass by Ildefonso. But in transition, Ildefonso had Ronald on him, and that can't be.
It's very obvious that Ildefonso is one of the number one assist men in the San Miguel team. But that's also the reason why he commits a lot of turnovers.
That's
because
right.
He has to give up the ball every time he's double-teamed.
There's that last play, brought to you by PLDT Text 135. If you can't say it, text it for free activation. Call 171. Talking about the numbers of Ildefonso, gentlemen, see, Ildefonso is averaging 7.5 rebounds. He's averaging 6 assists. He averaged 6 assists in the semis, and he also committed 5.5 turnovers.
It's almost like 1-1, no, Ron?
And that's not good.
That's not good. You won't accept that.
2-for-2 from the line, see, Freddy Abuda. It's 5-0. Laman po ang San Miguel ng lima.
This is the big matchup. Are they going to double here or not? They're not doubling. They're going to come in the paint.
Meneses turns. Sees an opening. Not quite. Rebound, Miracela. What's the logic there, Ron? Why aren't they bubbling at this moment?
Well, they're a little worried about the three-point shooting of
San Miguel.
Of San Miguel, and they're confident that Freddie's one of the best defenders. So
that's true. Freddie's been able to use his body without fouling Berhel and not letting him get to the sweet spot.
Here's David. Wala pa rin. Off rebound by Ildefonso, and still no points here for Barangay Ginebra. 4 minutes gone here in the first.
The basket's like a lead, has a lead on it for Barangay Ginebra.
Rosella, awkward shot, and Magtulis gets the rebound. Coach Alan Kaydick trying to tell his boys, push it up, push it up.
He's got to open the court up.
Magtulis faking, slipping and sliding. Meneses is open from long distance. No. Peña with another rebound here.
Varela is 0 out of 3 here in this first 5 minutes of the ballgame, and still no scores for Barangay Ginebra.
Peña with a big job off the board so far. He's averaging 4.5 rebounds.
Ooh!
Nice TLDT.
Gonna call timeout.
IDD long distance shot. That spectacular long distance shot was brought to you by PLDT NDD. Now as low as 3 pesos per minute, anytime and anywhere in the Philippines. Call 171 for free NDD activation. We'll be back. Welcome back, mga kaibigan, sa Araneta Coliseum. Game number 1 of the best of 7 All-Filipino Finals. Right now, lamang po San Miguel, 8-0 with 7:15 remaining in the first. And obviously, ang Barangay Ginebra has to regroup here, Dr. J.
Well, they just have to get the first 2 points. But one thing good for them is the only guy that's really hurting them is Rosella. He has had 2 3-point shots.
Yes.
No points from Siegel, no points from Ildefonso. So they're doing a good defensive job on those two guys.
Maliban
sa well, that's illegal defense on Dorian.
Yes.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, when he tries to go, but he doesn't know if he's going or he's coming.
Well, it's obvious they're gonna double input in the post, not Meneses.
All right.
That's obvious now.
So
what Allen needs to do, and he's done it, he's put Elmer in the game now, and now he's got to go to June to make him double, and hopefully Elmer can make a couple of threes on the weak side.
Coach Allen K. Dick looking for his first ever PBA crown.
Here it comes.
Here's Limpot. Dinoble ni Peña. Kick out play. Lago pulls the trigger. Bang!
Yes. Instant offense for a guy off the bench. But being able to adjust and see what the other coach is doing against you. No?
That spectacular long distance shot was brought to you by PLDT NDD. Now as low as 3 pesos per minute anytime and anywhere in the Philippines. Call 171 for free activation. Here they come. David. Hesitation move. Wilmer wrong. Hindi nakuha offensive rebound. Labuda picks it up.
You know, Wilmer has the right idea, but he must get that board. You know, he went in there. He's much bigger than the guy that was under him. You should be able to get the board and put it back up.
You're talking about the matchup a while ago. Here's Rosella again.
Oh!
He hits it again. That was another PLDT IDD long distance shot. That's his third of the game, and this must be a great sign for San Miguel, Ron, that this will open things up later on for the big man, Ildefonso and Siegel.
If Allen, you know, decides he's got to rotate quickly on Olsen, yes.
Lob shot from David, his first 2 points. And it's 11-5. Ani mga bante na San Miguel.
Well, they have to trust David. He has the most experience among the point guys playing in this kind of situation, and he can deliver.
In fact, Bal David and Will Marong are the only remaining players doon sa huling kampiyonato ng Barangay Ginebra back in 97, yung Commissioner's Cup. Rosella drops it off to Peña, left hand.
That was a terrible pass by Ildefonso. You don't throw a bounce pass.
Almost picked there by Lago.
You don't throw it on the perimeter.
Meneses, sinahanap si Limpot. They move it around. Offensive foul here called by referee Chua.
Wilmer on illegal pick on the weak side to screen for Elmer. He's got a cut to the basket. Illegal lead pick.
And now Banjo Calpito will check in for Wilmer Ong. Brief stint on the floor for Ong. As Calpito checks in for the first time.
Well, Calpito's blossomed with the coaching of Alan Kaidik and the Chutal age here. So, you know, I expect him to remain in the league for quite a while.
What does Calpito bring to the Ginebra
team? He's tough, man. He's a tough defender.
And he will compete.
And talk about competing. Here's a guy who's certainly a competitor, a winner at that. Daniel Defonso inside it. Lamang na po ang San Miguel ng sampo, 15-5. Bread and butter play here. Two-man game on the left side. Limpo turns, fakes. Cross court, Lago again. No, Ildefonso with the rebound.
June Limput's tired, and he played 48 minutes the other night. Look at his mouth, it's wide open. But I think a lot of it has to do with emotion. You get tired at the very beginning of the game, and he's tired. He's got his hands down already. He's put a lot in, never getting there.
And I'm sure he's feeling the crack. Oh, a great block. Good there block by Calpito. Super bukas el tapal mula kay Banzo Calpito.
That's another factor, you know. Ginebra had to play in 2 days, while San Miguel had 3 days rest.
That's right. There's a foul, or rather a whistle.
I think legal defense.
Legal defense call here.
Well, they get a free point here.
Legal on San Miguel. Well, Brgy Ginebra may not be putting up the points here, but in this particular play, Banjo Calpito timing his jump well. Butataka. That slow mo was brought to you by PLDT Text 135. If you can't say it, text it. For free activation, call 171.
All right, the game's going to be played now. Here comes the substitutions through, and here comes Mark. So we'll see how they match up. This is a big time for San Miguel to see if they can control Mark.
Caguioa checking in for Verhel Meneses. Nick Velasco has also been inserted into the game together with Dwight Lago. And Lago facing Lago here.
The two brothers are picking each other up, yeah, on offense and defense.
Maybe we should talk about that a little bit. There was a lot of emotion because of the death of the father.
That's right.
Getting the finals. Yeah. And I think that both sons would have loved to have their father watch them play in the finals.
Exactly.
Compete against each other.
I know Elmer shed some tears in the dugout the other night after we won.
Well, this is certainly a poignant moment for these two players. Elmer and Dwight facing each other in the finals.
Limpot missed his technical free throw shot earlier. He made this one, so that puts Ginebra at 6 points. San Miguel has a 9-point lead with 4 minutes left here in the first quarter.
Caguioa, first touch, Limpot sees an opening, goes inside, strong move from the main man.
Well, you better make sure that you're going to try to steal the ball from June. You better get it, because if they don't help, he's going to lay it up.
Ildefonso trying to take that ball away from behind, and that he left his feet there, or he left the ground. 15-8, 7-point lead here for San Miguel. Here's Danny. Trying to get back to inside pass. Malakas, napulot. Lago nilabas Kirasela. 3 seconds to shoot. He goes up. Strong.
Good closeout by Mark. He threw out the runner and made Olsen put it on the floor.
And just an unbelievable guy in terms of energy, Ron.
Yep.
He guards, he jumps. Now he takes a shot and he misses that one. Calpito offensive rebound. He's inside. Naipit. Loose ball. Nobody has it. Calpito is inside. Kicks it out to... Oh, ball David, voila! But good effort on the part of Calpito there.
Definitely. Yeah, I thought ball David threw up that shot a little haphazardly. Oh. He had all the time to take an easy shot.
Akala niya paubos na yung oras, eh, no? 15 contra 8. Lamang po San Miguel ng pito. 2:52 remaining here. Ildefonso.
They didn't double him.
No. Rebound by Limpot.
They didn't double him.
Only 2:40 remaining. Caguioa, baseline move. Laban ka. Buda. Oh, wala.
That's all the right moves. Just can't finish it.
Now, that's an interesting matchup. Abuda being put on Caguioa here, Ron.
Yeah, Freddie can't watch him. He's too quick. They'll have to double him.
If you were on the other side, who would you put on Caguioa here?
It wouldn't matter. I'd double him right away.
That's how much respect everybody has on this rookie. Here's Ildefonso. From the side, and it's now 17-8.
That's a shot you do not want to give Danny Ildefonso. He has sort of perfected that move, going to the baseline and fading away.
And Danny Ildefonso is just raising the level of his game. He averaged 18.5 points in the semifinals and shot 52.4% from the field. There's a foul, no, a traveling violation on Banjo Calpito. That'll take us to our second timeout here. A 9-point lead for the Beermen here in the first quarter of game number one. Couple of new faces in the game now. Ipinasok po si Rob Duat at si Boy Beats Victoria sa Panigas San Miguel. On the other hand, JJ Helterbrand and Alex Cusano back in the game. Semi-hook. Bad shot.
Oh, he's too far out for that jump hook of his now.
Yes.
He's not comfortable with that shot.
They play the perimeter. Caguioa.
Ooh.
There we go.
Bago almost got caught to the legal defense. Yeah.
Helter Brand sa labas pa rin. They've got 4 seconds sa kanilang shot clock. Alam ni Caguioa, he takes the shot and his first 2 points of the game. Now, Rob Duwal is taking on Caguioa now.
They can't take him. It doesn't matter who's out there.
Mark the spark.
If he makes that shot, he makes that shot, unless you want to go flying and doubling him.
7 points ang lamang po ng San Miguel. Pick and roll play did not materialize. Velasco kicks it out again. 4 seconds sa kanilang shot clock. Victoria.
Can't give him that.
The two-point guards of San Miguel are playing very well.
That is a PLDT IDD long distance shot, and San Miguel back on top by 10 here. That much time remaining in the quarter. Here's Mark. And a foul.
They went to double team him that time.
But he was too late. And Mark is wise. He saw where the double team was coming from. He went to the baseline.
Just a magnificent pickup here for Barangay Ginebra. Mark the Spark Caguioa from Glendale Community College. Third pick overall this year.
I think Andy and Ying kind of knew what we were going to do because we told them we weren't going to draft a Regal. And they talked to us. We said we weren't taking a Regal, and maybe it surprised them. But I think they figured it out that we had someone else in mind.
And the only guy he hurt was Louis Alas. They wanted him. Mobiline wanted this guy.
6 seconds to go. Nice pick going up. Yes. Excellent move from Daniel DeFonso. That much time remaining. It expires as we say it. And San Miguel dominating the first quarter of game number one behind Daniel DeFonso. Lamang po ang Beerman ng 12 after the first 12 minutes of action. Amin sa ating mga kababayan sa Ilocanja. Welcome sa inyong bayan ng superstars, Noli Iyala po. Kasama si Dr. J. Andy Howe at si Ron Jacobson. As we open up the second quarter here, Dwight Lago with another PLDT IDD long distance shot brought to you by PLDT MDD, now as low as 3 pesos per minute, anytime, anywhere in the Philippines. Call 171 for free MDD activation.
Well, the lead is 15 points right now as we see this attempt by Helterbrand, and that's because of the 5 3-point shots that San Miguel has hit.
Yes.
And they put Corsano on Siegel last time down. I don't know why.
Illegal defense will be called on Barangay Ginebra. Here, this quarter is brought to you by Siemens Mobile Phone.
Even though they got caught with illegal defense, I like that the fact that the players are talking and say, you know, I'm supposed to pick up this guy, you're supposed to pick up that guy. You know?
A little more communication, a little bit of a lethargic start here for Barangay Ginebra.
Yes, I think it's nerves. And the shooting percentage is just terrible.
That's terrible. Right.
But, you know, it can pick up. Once a guy like Meneses can get something for them, they'll pick up. Or a Julian Pot.
That's right. As we take a look at the numbers here, Dr. J.
Yeah, it's only 21% for Ginebra and 47% for San Miguel.
Helter Brand. Strong move. Nice block there by Rob Duat. Super Bukas El Tapal. Statistics a while ago brought to you by QuickTight, the all-in-one glue technology by Loctite. Here's Dynamite Danny up against Alex Crisano. Inside to Nick Velasco.
That's a mismatch there.
They go to that matchup. Short stab, voila. Crisano helping out and gets the board. What kind of adjustments have to be made here, Ron, on the part of Barangay Ginebra? Offensively, they're not doing too well.
Well, if they're getting good shots, like Andy said, the question is, it's just not going in.
Ooh, what a super focus il capo from Danny Siegel.
But it's very obvious, if they're going to rely on Alex Grisano to score, they're not going to win.
Yeah, he's not going to give them 30 or 40 here.
Well, we've not seen Verel Meneses to take too many attempts here. Lago from long distance, no. Offensive rebound by Duat. Here's Siegel. Gives it to Duat. To Velasco. And the foul.
They're just out-executing the Ginebra right now.
And the championship points is just showing here this early.
Yes.
Almost half of this Barangay Ginebra team is in the first ever PBA finals. Yeah. As you take a look at this slow-mo brought to you by PLDT Text 135. If you can't say it, text it. For free activation, call 171.
Allen needs just to keep them in the game. You know, get to the second half where everybody settles down and you can make some adjustments and just keep them in the game.
Yeah, he's got to convince his players to stay in there. Yeah. Not worry about the lead. We're only in the second quarter early.
That's correct.
Alan made some pronouncements, Dr. J, just before the game. Sabi niya, tinalo namin ang Pure Foods, tinalo namin ang Shell. There's no reason we shouldn't beat San Miguel. That should be, I mean,
maybe there is a reason. Maybe San Miguel is better than those other two teams.
Yeah, that's right.
Maybe that's the reason why San Miguel is here.
And, you know, San Miguel is being able to use its bench right now the way Jong wants it. Because they're leading, they're doing everything correctly. You know, the substitutions are coming in very well.
And that's why they're leading by 17 now, 27 to 10. And the Kings have yet to score here in the second quarter. Helterbrand. Look at the defense here, just scrambling for San Miguel. There's a double team. Inside to Calpito, he loses the leather. And San Miguel controlling the tempo here. Coach Uchico saying, slow it down, we're up by 17. Here's the Dynamite falling away. No, help him Brandon the rebound.
He hasn't scored, has he?
That's right. If not, this game's over. He scores the way he scores.
JJ, out to Caguioa, long distance shot. Bam.
Yes, you can see it coming.
That's his first PLDT IDD long distance shot. That spectacular long distance shot was brought to you by PLDT NDD. Now as low as 3 passes per minute, anytime and anywhere in the Philippines. Call 171 for free NDD activation. Lead is down to 14. Inside, and a foul, and one play for San Miguel.
So difficult because San Miguel knows where the double team is coming from. They're able to rotate the ball well.
Well, I think you said it before the game started that the inside game of San Miguel's dominant, and that's what's happening. They're kicking it in, and then they're making the correct passes and making easy shots for everybody.
There you see that last pass inside to Nick Velasco. Slow-mo brought to you by PLDT. Text 135. If you can't say it, text it. For free activation, call 171.
Crisano has to be in the game, and they got to be able to let him defend without doubling.
Hindi na kompleto ang three-point play ni Nick Velasco.
You know, his free throw shooting has gone down in the semifinals.
Yes.
Nick is a very good free throw shooter.
He went to the line in the semis twice, and he missed both.
Surprisingly, he used to be about almost a 90% free throw shooter.
Well, in the conference, close to that, Dr. J is about 78%. And certainly that is not the Nick Velasco that we know, from the line at least. In the meantime, basket here for Barangay Ginebra, cutting down the lead somewhat to 14. 8 minutes and 15 remaining in the second quarter. Narito si Sigel, nilabas Quilago. Ball movement for San Miguel, Duwat going up, basket again. There's just no defense here. Well, 31 points on the board now for San Miguel.
Now it's a better matchup for Berhel. They'll have to double team here.
They go to the other side. Calpito spinning. He's in the baseline. Nice move. Nice shot for Banjo Calpito.
Back-to-back baskets underneath the basket for Banjo Calpito.
Well, that's all predicated on what you said. They're doubling Verhelly. Reverse the ball. They're going out, rotating out, and they're kicking it underneath. So
Banjo Calpito averaged 4.5 points a game in the semis. Here's Siegel from long distance. Another PLDT IDD long distance shot.
Anybody else take that shot? That was a bad shot. Nick Velasco had ball the beat underneath the basket. There was no way ball is going to guard him. Yeah.
Still might have been a bad shot.
And San Miguel is just pulling away from the long distance shots. Here's another one. And it's raining threes here, Ron, in this kind of a game, you know.
Well, if Ginebra can make some stops, that's good for Ginebra. They get up and down the floor and not get hammered inside so much.
Size-wise, Barangay Ginebra is not matching up well with San Miguel.
That's correct, Ron. Yeah. And Jong said it in his comments that, you know, they got quickness, we got size. We'll see who wins.
Here's Limpot off the glass. And June is just struggling here in the first half.
But I think that's why Alan said what he said. So did Shell and so did Pure Foods have the size.
That's right.
And that's why he said, well, we can beat them, we can beat, you know.
Just a mind game in this best of seven series. Just like any war. Lago from long distance. No.
A little bit of cool off here.
Well, San Miguel was scorching. And there just has to be a plateau somewhere.
Yeah, Ginebra's not out of this game by a long way.
This is just a 14-point lead inside to Calpito. Top of the Victoria, and that's the foul. That time, ball movement, Dr. J, na Mayani para sa Barangay Ginebra.
We're beginning to realize what San Miguel is doing now.
And Calpito has been a big help off the bench here. 4 points already and going for his fifth and sixth points.
What cannot happen for Ginebra is Mark to get his third foul here. And Allen having to take him out. And
Caguioa has two personal fouls. He has 5 points in the ballgame. He missed his first two shots and then made a couple, including a three-point shot, and Calpito makes his fifth point of the game. Ildefonso back. Caguioa getting some instructions. He will sit down for Brgy Ginebra. In the meantime, Rosella also back in the game.
What Alan told me, you got two fouls. We'll rest you a couple minutes, put you back in so you don't...
And this awesome front line for San Miguel. Back in the game, Velasco and the two Dannys combining with Rosella and Duat in the backcourt.
You know, Nolly, I think the backcourt players of San Miguel are also being challenged because a lot of people are saying the backcourt of the other team is better.
Yes. And that's what happened in the Shell Series, Dr. J. Usana nalo San Miguel rather than Brgy Ginebra. Sa backcourt nila.
Ildefonso shooting threes and never win the game.
You don't like that.
Here's Limpot. Wala pa rin. Rebound picked up by Siegel. And they're running. But the red shirts are down for defense. 5:35 remaining here in the second quarter. Siegel is wide open. He has all day. No. Rebound by Meneses. Lead pass. Magtulis.
There's Baldavid.
Both teams missing at this stage of the game. Here's Valdemir going baseline. Nilabas ki Magtulis. Meneses will take a three. Now he goes up for a three. No. Rebound ni Calpito. He's inside. And Banjos just playing a terrific offensive game here.
All desire.
Indeed. Banjo Calpito, a former Santa Lucia player, now showing his stuff for the Kings. And he's trying to lead the Kings back into this game. Dr. Trusted Alaksan, number one sa sakit ng katawan, doble bisa, doble galing. Welcome back, mga kaibigan. Game number one. Right now, ang Ginebra ay dahan-dahan na bumabalik dito. They're down by 12 after trailing by as many as 17.
Well, Plato splits his charities, cuts the lead down to 11. He's 3 out of 4 from the free throw line. He's doing a great job on defense and off the boards.
And as you said, Ron, Alan Kaidik just has to keep his team within striking distance and they'll settle down.
And Ginebra's got to do one more thing that's really important. Get the crowd involved. Get the Ginebra fans involved.
Well, there it is.
To hear that now.
Well, they need a streak. They need a couple, three baskets, so you'll start hearing the Ginebra chant, all right?
And that just energizes anybody.
Mm-hmm.
And right now, if you talk about energy, well, San Miguel has not been able to do anything, at least so far. Only their first turnovers in 6 minutes of the first quarter. There's a tap out here.
That was surprising. They doubled Verhel that time with Freddie on him.
Mm.
When the game started, they didn't.
Kanina po yung statistics brought to you by QuickTight, the all-in-one glue technology by Loctite. Here's Meneses.
I guess they want to show him different looks.
Well, it might be who's in the game also.
Limpot, hesitating. 4 seconds, ang kanilang shot clock. 2 seconds to shoot. David, floater, wala. Rebound, picked up by Siegel.
Those are very flat shots that Baldavid is taking.
Yes.
You know, and he knows it, that those are not the shots that he usually takes.
San Miguel in a record 23rd PBA Finals appearance here, and there's a tap out. As we lead in now first to Janel So, and he's with one of our PBA friends, Senator June Magsaysay.
Okay, punong-punong po tayo dito ngayon sa Arenado Coliseum ng mga popular faces, and one of them is here. To my left is Senator June Magsaysay. Hi, sir. Welcome to the PBA.
Happy to be here, Janelle.
Okay, sir. Nabalitaan ko po nung college, nagba-basketball din kayo. Pero ngayon, talagang you were closely following the NBA. May favorite team po ba kayo doon?
Well, sa NBA, sa US mainland, I follow the Los Angeles Lakers because of Kobe Bryant.
At ngayon, dito naman po sa ating bayan ng superstars, meron po kayong favorite team?
Mukhang itong team na ito, kasama sila Jun Limpot and Baldavid. I like the way they move around and yung style nila, I like it.
Alam nyo, sir, maganda po yan na yung sports kasama po ng part ng ating buhay, no? Dahil we learn a lot of values in sports that we can apply in our daily lives. And what have you learned from your years of playing basketball and following those two basketball leagues, NBA and PBA, na nagagamit po ninyo sa inyong pamumuhay?
That's a good question sapagkat when you play sports, especially basketball or soccer football, you learn how to work with others. Meron kang tinatawag na cooperation and teamwork. And you look at the discipline of the individuals working towards a common goal. So, mahalaga dyan yung physical stamina, yung discipline, at saka yung teamwork.
Okay, thank you so much, sir. And very well said. Enjoy the game.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
Senator Magsaysay with Janelle So during that interview, Barangay Ginebra making a bit of a run here. The lead has been cut down to just 9. Ildefonso challenging. No. Rebound by Meneses.
He has had a lot of defensive boards. He may not be scoring, but Meneses pick up a lot of defensive boards.
5 rebounds already para kay Meneses.
Verhel's done a great job sacrificing himself for this team.
Here's Limpot, close range, and the main
We got a game. We got a game.
Has cut down the lead to 7. You talk about the 6th man here, the Ginebra crowd coming back, and, well, this is exactly the momentum that they want.
Well, San Miguel has his crowd. It's been quiet for quite a while.
That's
now.
Right.
Here it comes. Here comes the chant.
Limpot with 5 points. Siegel missing that one. Picks up his own miss. He goes up. Floater. Yes.
Now, if they could have rebounded there and went down and scored, the crowd really would have gotten in. Now they just quieted the crowd. The crowd's out of it again.
36-27 with a minute and 40 seconds left.
This looks like one of those barangay pageants where you put your hand on top of the contestant and say, give me the loudest clap. Here's Limpot.
Surprisingly, now it's Ginebra scoring on the inside. Calpito's 9 points in this quarter. Jun Limpot has just scored back-to-back baskets here.
7 in the game for the main man.
Allen changed his mind. He's not going to bring Crisano in.
Only a minute and 13 remaining in the first half. Ildefonso. Lipe Seracena Bahagia. He goes to the corner. No. And there's a whistle. And a foul. Laban kay Limpot, it seems.
Yes.
Jun Limpot will pick up his second foul here. And the Kings will call timeout. They are within striking distance. And welcome back, mga kaibigan, as we take a look at some of the celebrities here. Of course, the former PSC chairman, Philip Wico, on hand. Cynthia Norton, ang current PSC chairman, also there. And of course, our big boss, Boss Vic Del Rosario, ng Viva Vintage Sports. And my favorite senator, si former press secretary, Dong Puno, also on hand here today. Enjoying this game. Rosella Salabas. Yes! That is another PLDT IDD long distance shot.
That is so big. You know, that's his 4th 3-point shot in the first half alone.
Are you surprised that they're using this weapon as much as they're doing it, Ron, in the first half?
Olsen, they're going to give it to the open man on the 3-point. He's going to shoot it. It doesn't matter who's open. Olsen happens to be the guy. I guess Allen's not rotating out quickly enough on him. They're more worried about Siegel.
And Rosella's just making them pay.
Yes.
The lead is back up to 10. Only 20 seconds remaining here. Here's Dynamite back.
Olsen is open.
Taking a corner jumper. He goes closer and he is just red hot.
I mean, he's killing it. He has 14 in the ballgame.
Just an unbelievable performance here for Rara Rosella.
And they can foul and they're going to use that. They still have 2 fouls to give after that.
Rosella was in that... team that San Miguel beat back in 1994 with the Pure Foods team. And that was the last taste of a championship by San Miguel, of an all-Filipino championship. Right now, there's a 30-second timeout here. And time to grab that ice-cold San Miguel Light, only 13 pesos at a store near you. San Miguel Light, full beer flavor, same beer alcohol, but it's less filling. And Ron Jacobs, obviously, you know, just on the lighter side here, the reports headed that you were going to go to Boracay just to take a break from all of this, and it must be just a relief for you to be sitting here in the panel rather than trying to think what to do here.
Yeah, but it's a pleasure. I mean, it's the problem is it's like two sons, you know, in a boxing match against each other. I would hate to ever see that with a parent or something like that. But I'm enjoying it very much. I'm not that emotional involved, you know, yelling and screaming and things like that, so it's great. And my blood pressure is fine.
This is a very important play here. As you take a look at si Philip
Salvador, of course.
Another 30-second timeout called by San Miguel.
Oh, well, they're going to make a substitution so a guy can get in and foul, I think.
And they also realized that Caguioa was put in by Allen.
That's
so
right.
Most probably the guy's going to come out, take it strong to the basket, take a jump shot. You know, Ron has a favorite play. You know, when Ron beat me a couple of times.
You know his team very well.
And he had a very nice play, which I've never seen anybody copy. You know, I'm really surprised because I always thought that you can imitate in basketball whatever is good. He had a nice pattern there where he used Jeff Moore at the top of the key. And you always thought Jeff was going to drive into the basket. Everybody be rushing at him. People be coming on the sides and give a bounce pass to get a layup. Man.
Well... Tommy ran something similar.
We'll talk about that at the half. The 30-second timeout. Time to grab the last code. San Miguel, only 13 pesos at store near you. San Miguel, full beer flavor, same beer alcohol, but it's less filling. Only 5.7 seconds remaining at the half. Oh, in the first half, and...
Not a good shot.
But he still has an other shot. He's blocked. Super focus is doubled by Danny Siegel. And that'll do it for the first half of game number one. The Beermen, led by as many as 17, went up 8-0 early in this game. And they are up by a dozen after the first 24 minutes of action.
Are they using a different person now?
We'll see what happens here.
Si Crisano tumatawag kay Defonso. Inilabas Kirasera, he has had the hot hand. Perfect from long distance. He comes closer, Malakas. Peña with an offensive rebound and put back. And you got super wide bodies there, Dr. J. And obviously, the perimeter, the shaded area is just being controlled by San Miguel here.
That's right. That's a power player that they have in Peña.
That's a wall. Magtulis from long distance. Malakas. Ildefonso gets the rebound.
That was a bad shot. They rotated out and he held the ball too long. He's got to penetrate and kick it or drive it to the basket.
This game is as hot as the political season. Here's Peña working. He goes up, blocked by Limpot. That's a super focus El Tapal. And then Peña coming down with the ball and a traveling has been called on Dorian Peña.
Well, it's obvious that Ginebra's not going to double team against Peña. They're only going to do that against Daniel Defonso.
Well, that's the adjustment they made. They made the switch and put Alex on him. They're not going to double anybody.
Here's Meneses.
Of the three-point shots of San Miguel.
Well, adding the ball. Laban Meneses. There's a tap from behind. Coming from Ildefonso. Racela racing down court. Binigayot. Valdavid. It'll go up. It will remain with the Beermen, however, but great defense on the flash.
It was very good defense and terrible defense by Crisano. He tried to stop Olson Rosella in the backcourt in the fast break. He's not going to stop that in open court.
There's a tendency of big men to try to do that often, you know. You can't do that. All you do is get back, you know.
Hopefully not on my team.
We remember the terrible mistake of Codinero, of course, fouling Olson Rosella in that Mobiline San Miguel game. Here's Meneses. Gets away. Oh, super focus El Tapal by Danny Siegel. Just timing his jump well. Here's Dynamite. He looked like Peña. He's inside. He may have traveled.
He's traveling.
Wow, from defense to offense. But first, this magnificent shot block from Dynamite Danny. Just timing his shot block well. That's Lomo brought to you by PLDT Text 135. If you can't say it, text it. For free activation, call 171.
But that was a bad play by Limput. He cut through to bring his man in when Meneses had a mismatch on Olsen.
In fact, they almost bumped into each other.
That's right. He should have stayed out. He just misread it. And they work on that every day. He just misread it.
Siegel is just working double time on defense. Here's Valdavid. Voila. Abuda gets the rebound.
Oh, yeah.
Siegel is averaging 0.3 of a shot block per game. Today, he must have at least two or three already in the game.
Two shot blocks in the game.
Wow. Half a quarter gone by here in the third. San Miguel continues to lead. Lamang sila ng sapo. Short stab. Tapik na punta kay Meneses. Pero ang Barangay Ginebra, Dr. J, hindi makalapit dito.
Well, they haven't been able to capitalize on their defensive stops.
Yes. And the perimeter shooting still not falling for them. Here's Meneses. Nice pick, gets away. And a spectacular move from the aerial voyager.
That's a lot better for Ginebra. Verhel against Freddy outside than inside, like it was in the first quarter.
That's right. Well, Meneses took 7 attempts back in the first half, made only 1. There's a whistle here, and this will be an offensive foul.
If they can get a stop here, the crowd will get into it.
They're down by 8. Ang Barangay Ginebra, John Wichico, looking up and seeing that San Miguel up by 8 here. Dr. Trusted Alaksan, number one sa sakit ng katawan, doble bisa, doble galing. Well, hindi nasamantala ng Barangay Ginebra pagkakataon, unable to cut down the lead after a timeout was called. Here's Ildefonso, sapal sa likod, super bugas sa tapal, Monaki Meneses, and the ball touched last by Ildefonso. At least the defense is now beginning to show on the part of the Barangay Ginebra Kings.
Well, the difference is they're not doubling. They're collapsing.
Here's that last play, Meneses from behind. Loma brought to you by PLDT, text 135. If you can't say it, text it. For free activation, call 171. Meneses, sinagasaan siya Buda, Benitez, nice last pass. And the lead is down to 6 here, Dr. J. Momentum swinging now on the part of the Kings.
Well, it seems that way, you know. As a matter of fact, they were able to bring in two fresh players ahead of San Miguel. So you can see that I think something's going right for Ginebra now.
Ildefonso is triple team, kicks it out to Rara Rasela. Goes inside, napitawa ng bola. Here's Valdavid. 2-on-2. Waits for his teammates wisely.
Very good decision by the point.
Sakanto Silago, Meneses. In the left corner court, up against Abuda. 1-on-1 play, he goes up. Bang! And the lead is down to 4. And this is being done with Caguioa also on the bench.
Right.
Again, Meneses is parking it this time.
Now the crowd's in it. Now we'll see the poise of San Miguel to get the right shot.
Team manager Ira Manikis egging on the crowd here.
Illegal defense. Illegal defense.
They didn't go back. You know, after Siegel kicked the ball out, the guy continued to stay at the post.
You know, I noticed the same ploy that you used back in Shell, in the Shell game, game number 5, where Alan Kadick just sat Mark Caguioa for the entire third quarter.
Well, it all kind of depends on Verhel. I mean, if Verhel's got it going, we don't want to take Verhel out of the game. If Verhel's struggling, then we'll sub earlier.
And that's why Caguioa, when he entered in the fourth quarter of that game, was just full of energy. He was just well rested.
And if we can get the right matchup, we'll put them together. All right.
Yes.
And,
the other thing that you used in that Shell series was using Verhel as a point guard.
Well, we had to have foul trouble, but Verhel, remember, in the first conference last year, played some point before JJ was eligible.
That's right. There's a foul by Lago, who's now taking on Siegel here. 5-point lead for San Miguel after the technical free throw was converted. First foul on Elmer Lago. Second team foul on San Miguel.
On Ginebra.
Or rather on Ginebra.
San Miguel has no team fouls yet. We only had 3:38 left here in the third quarter.
Nagigirian sa poste si Siegel. Na double team. Nice getaway. He goes up and that will fall.
That's a great advantage San Miguel has. It's happened twice. It happened in the first half when they made a little run. Siegel made a shot in there.
And every time Barangay Ginebra comes up with something, Siegel seems to be the answer here.
Well, if Ginebra can score here, they'll keep the momentum.
Meneses, Laban kay Buda. Oh, yes, what a play by Meneses. He's taking over now, Dr. J.
That's right. And that's the reason why he's on the floor. You know, Berhel is the most experienced player there on that squad.
Meneses looking for his first PBA crown in 6 years. Offensive foul by Dynamite Danny. His second personal foul. Barangay Ginebra is coming back. They're making a game out of this one. Samantala mga kaibigan, pasok muna natin ating Gold Eagle PBA Pinakakondisyong Player of the Week. And our Gold Eagle Beer Pinakakondisyong Player of the Week is no other than Olsen Rosella of San Miguel. His 2-game averages of 16 points and almost 100% from 3-point range. 10 out of 10 from the free throw. This condition portion Player of the Week is brought to you by the Gold Eagle Beer Pinakondisyon Para Bukas.
Meneses is making the right decisions right now. And Ginebra has found a leader here in Verhel. Get themselves back into the ball game. San Miguel has committed 6 turnovers in this third quarter. Barangay Ginebra only 1.
5-point lead for the Beermen. Kanina yung ating statistics brought to you by QuickTight, the all-in-one glue technology by Loctite.
Punta naman sa poste kay Danny, binabasa niya.
Double team. Kilapit na lamang, muti na magaw. Here's Siegel. Napayungan ni Lago pero may foul. Yung tinawag si referee Chua underneath.
There's been a mistake on the San Miguel bench, I think. Boybitz usually comes in the second time out and he's still sitting.
Now, how do you read that, Ron?
I don't know. And Boybitz seems to be okay. I don't know if they're going to wait till the quarter or they've forgotten about it.
Rosella has just taken one shot here in the second half after making 14 points in the first. And Ildefonso working on Limpot here.
Unless they're just going to match up Boybitz against JJ and Olsen against Bao. Maybe.
Rock, ano ba reading mo dyan?
Well, probably, alam mo naman na si Yuchiko nagbabasa rin ng anong gagawin niya. Olsen did a pretty good job against Bao David earlier, so...
He forgot. He's going in now.
Ayan na, papasok si Boybitz Victoria.
Ay, yung sistema talaga ng San Miguel, you know, it's there, you know.
Talagang nandun.
No matter what.
Clockwork. Mark Caguioa, by the way, is in the game. Meneses checking out. He had a magnificent third quarter here, Dr. J.
Yeah, not only scoring, he was helping Jun Limpot with a couple of nice passes. But again, San Miguel ups the lead to 7 on those free throws.
The timeouts have really hurt Ginebra. They had 2 runs and twice the timeout came in this quarter when they had the runs.
Yes. Yeah.
It really hurt them in the runs.
Calpito kicks it out to Mark the Spark. He takes the shot. 7 in the game for Caguioa.
He has so much confidence in his game. For a guy, a rookie, to shoot that thing in a finals, yes, you know, coming off the bench.
He is now 2 out of 4 from the field, 1 out of 1 from three-point range. Here's Rosella up against Caguioa. Nice pick. Rara Rosella sees an opening. Oh, what a move! Excellent move by Rosella.
You know what happened there? Baldavid rotated wrong. He was going to rotate here to the strong side.
That's right.
Then he went back. Yeah. And he should have been able to pick up that man.
Here, well, let's watch this again.
You see, Bal wanted to go there. Now he goes back. And he leaves that guy open, so there was no choice but for Calpito to come in and help.
Three-point play coming up here. Siya nga pala, tumutok sa Bantay Halalan 2001 para sa malayang paglalahad ng pinakahuling kaganapan sa May 14 elections. Dito po sa IBC 13. Abangan niyo po yan. Still a 7-point lead as a 3-point play is not completed here. 1:15 remaining in the third. Here's the flash. Delago pulls the trigger. Bang! That's a tough shot.
That's a designed play, and he was wide open for that 3-point shot.
That was a PLDT IDD long distance shot brought to you by PLDT NDD. Now as low as 3 pesos per minute in any time, anywhere in the Philippines. Call 171 for free NDD activation. And kagad silagot naman ang San Miguel.
Siegel is a second half player.
Yes.
And he's a fourth quarter player.
Too. Oh, yes. Dr. J knows that very well. Siegel just burned them 27 points in the second half against Red Bull. Here's David throwing up a prayer.
Well, I think he wanted somebody to follow it up. He saw his teammate coming in.
Only 28 seconds to go here in the quarter. Here's Siegel again. Nilabas Kiduat goes baseline. Atapik sa likod. Kept alive here by Ildefonso. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Rosella. Inside. Oh, dangerous pass picked up by Baldavid.
They got all kinds of fouls to give. They got all kinds of fouls to give. See if they give.
That much time remaining here. There's a foul.
Did you use a 30-second timeout here?
That's a bad foul. That gives him a third foul. That's bad stuff. That's bad stuff.
Also, Rosella will sit down now. Victoria checks in with only 3.9 seconds remaining.
That was a bad, bad foul. Whoever Siegel's watching right now, I go to him and see if Siegel fouls again.
Go. There's Lago.
Go to the basket.
He goes up. No.
Should have gone to the basket.
And that'll end the quarter here.
Siegel couldn't have fouled.
That's right. Well, San Miguel staving off the third quarter storm. But we've got one more quarter to play here in game number 1. Final quarter ng ating pong laban. Bali yala po kasama si Dr. J. Andy Haren, Coach Ron Jacobs. As Brgy Ginebra trails by 6 here. Nabitawan ni Caguioa bola. Victoria has it.
Well, they got the opportunity to put Verhel and Mark together because Siegel's out of the game.
That's
and Matulis
right.
And Elmer can't don't play. Now, they should spread the court and get things done. Ginebra here.
Take a look at the quarter scoring brought to you by Quick Dive, the all-in-one blue technology by Loctite. 2 free throws for big third quarter there for Brgy Ginebra. And now Ildefonso at the line.
he's been shooting foul shots poorly lately.
That is true. At hindi katakata kayo, Dr. J, because Ildefonso has been a steady hand from the line, no?
That's right. He has 13 points in the ball game, but he's been struggling in the last round of the eliminations.
We now feature our close-ups, killer confident smiles of the night. Get killer smile, killer fresh breath, and killer confidence only from all new germ-killing close-ups. 2-for-2 from the line, see Danny I. They dubbed him as the demolition man, and right now, San Miguel back on top by 8. Half a minute gone by here in the quarter. Caguioa. From long distance, no. Now here's the dangerous part here. San Miguel comes up with its own run and opens up this thing here in the fourth quarter. Ildefonso, laban kay Banjo Calpito. Nice pass inside. Rob Duato, tulis na tulis. Gets his own miss. Deep inside. Ball taken away by Meneses. And counter steal by Rob Duato. Here's Ildefonso. Challenging Calpito, jump shot, short. Tumalbog palabas, tapik, nakuha ni Caguioa. Now, Caguioa and Meneses playing together here, Ron.
They'll try to get the double team on Verhel and then spread the court with Mark and JJ, and Calpito will cut.
There's a double team, Caguioa has
there
to
it
there. Helter Brand open, bang! Yeah.
That's a good advantage that they have right now. You know, you can isolate Verhel, you can isolate Caguioa. They're going to have to double team. They're going to have to move that ball around.
JJ Helterbrand was a 25% three-point shooter in the semifinals, lower than his conference average.
He made a big three in the fifth game.
That's right.
And that's a big three to keep him in this game.
Indeed, they're down by 5 here. Here's an illegal defense against the Barangay Ginebra Kings at the 10-14 mark as we take a look at Commissioner's Row here. Consul Eddie De Guzman, kasama po ni Executive Director Sunny Barrios, who celebrated his birthday yesterday, si Consul Eddie De Guzman, kasama na rin ang kanyang kapatid na si Ador. Welcome sa inyong bayan ng superstars at kayo pong lahat na nanonood sa amin sa game number 1. Kami po natutuwang makasama kayong lahat dito sa Big Dome.
Lalo na si Commissioner Jim Bernalino.
That's right.
I heard he checked out of the hospital. He's back at home and probably watching the game, which he shouldn't, but he will.
Kamusta po kayo, Commissioner Jun? We hope you're recovering as quickly as possible. Here's an inside incursion off an offensive rebound, Ron.
Big time rebound, three-point play.
That's what's one thing that Nick Velasco has brought to this team, just tenacious rebounding underneath.
It was a great trade for San Miguel. It made him, instead of being a pretender, it made him a contender and a champion team.
Well, they won championships right away when he came in.
That's right.
And those two guys are certainly very happy.
Yes.
Well, that slow-mo was brought to you by PLDT Text 135. If you can't say it, text it for free activation. Call 171. A lot of people are saying now, Ron, that you know, this San Miguel team not only is a champion team, it's now beginning to look like the traces of 89, maybe.
Well, it's pretty close. I mean, since 98, they've been in how many finals now? Two finals in 99, they won. Two finals in 2000, they won. Now, the final here, that's pretty good.
Nakita po natin si Mr. Henry Coanco kanina. There's a shot by Caguioa, wala.
He has the shot. He has missed two of those coming out.
And Coach Uchico is upset. They're not rotating out on him.
That's right.
And to me, that's good coaching. He's not satisfied. He's missing. He's upset they're not defending it.
Do what? Nilabas Kilago. 10 seconds of the shot clock. Victoria. 8 seconds to shoot. Ildefonso knows it. He drives strong, kicks it out. Duat, 3 seconds to shoot. Bailout shot, no.
That's a bad play by Duat. He should have passed the ball to the shooter.
Here's Meneses. Oh, crossover move. Bumped by Victoria, and let's see a whistle here.
A foul given up here by Boybits Victoria.
Good foul.
And Jong's telling him he should pass the ball. He was spelling team with an I that time.
They were teammates, no, Dr. J, in that 95 team with Sunkist, si Victoria?
Yeah, and
Meneses. That's
Meneses,
right.
They beat Alaska in the championship.
That's right.
On a three-point shot by Berhel, which sent the game to overtime, a seventh game.
Got a great memory, I mean.
That's why he's
I remember your place. That's 1985, 86.
Here's Calpito, deep inside. Nilabas kay Crisado. Hesitating, now comes closer. Oh, overshoots the mark.
Again, I will tell you, if Crisado's going to expect to score, they will lose here.
If he starts shooting 12 to 15 footers, then there's a problem somewhere. Here's Ildefonso. Bodying up is Crisano. 9 seconds on the shot clock. He goes baseline and a foul by Alex Crisano.
A hand check foul.
They're going to get in penalty here and they'll be in trouble. Because that's one thing San Miguel could do is take advantage of penalty.
And we take you now to our CMG swipe of the game. Ito po yung agaw kanina ni Ildefonso laban kay Verel Meneses. There you go. That was the CMG swipe of the game brought to you by CMG of Australia. Plan ahead, get ahead.
Verel will play the point.
Some adjustments here in the fourth.
Yeah, that's traveling. Oh, that's a, but a foul was called.
Foul called by referee Chua underneath here. Ronald Magtulis is charged for this one. His first fourth team foul. Pangapat na team foul ng Barangay Ginebra. First personal foul on Magtulis, the hero in that Pure Food series. Let's watch it again. Slow-mo brought to you by PLDT Text 135. If you can't say it, text it. For free activation, call 171.
7 seconds on the shot clock.
8:27 remaining here in the quarter. It's still a 9-point lead for the Beermen. And they're holding off here, Dr. J.
That's right. I know.
Walang mandi magaige. Whoa, what a shot.
What quarter man.
Unbelievable shot.
I mean, he's been silent in the first half, so you know he's going to explode somewhere.
He was leaning and falling down. Here's Caguioa. Yes.
This guy knows how to make the adjustments. He wasn't hitting his three-point shot. He brings it closer to the basket.
Well, there's a mismatch. There's no point guard out there, and so they're going to post up boy bits either with Verhel or
Mark.
The question is, will they get back on defense if they miss?
Uh-oh. This shot tipped in by Velasco. Natipik palabas. Siegel has it. Kicks it out to Ildefonso. Short stab. And San Miguel just playing like a team.
Yeah, they're so determined. You can see that.
Well, June's not in there now, and he must be tired. And I don't like Ginebra's chances with Calpito and Alex playing major minutes together.
In the meantime, foul away from the ball here. Victoria will be called for this one. As Caguioa was posting down low.
Foul number one, Boyman's Victoria.
As we take you to our timeout here in the fourth quarter, the San Miguel Beermen continue to hang tough here. They're on top by 11, 68-57. Oras po natin, it's a final quarter, 7.5. Baldavid is checked back in. Limpot is also in the game now. Freddy Abuda also checked in for Rob Duat. Caguioa against three people. Inside to Crisano, wala! And the rebound tapped out by Mark Caguioa. Sayang.
That's a great pass by Caguioa. Crisano.
I agree, Andy. A great play. Great vision.
Too bad he didn't make the shot. Let's watch it again against three players inside. Crisano was wide open.
I mean, just a glass.
He could have just dunked that ball.
Either use the glass or he dunk it.
Here's Siegel.
That's a foul.
And that's the problem now for Ginebra you were mentioning.
Now they're in penalty and it's deep trouble.
You know, if you talk about the matchup problem for San Miguel with Mark Caguioa, there's also a matchup problem on the San Miguel side, or rather in the Ginebra side with Siegel, Ron.
Oh, for sure. I mean, but every team has that problem.
That's right.
Because he can play the small, the shooting guard or the small forward, and the size and his lift.
They talk about sibling rivalry in this series, of course, but if game one is any indication, this is going to be a long drawn out war, Dr. J.
I would think so. I think Ginebra entered this game with a lot of emotion, but it also told on them, on their nerves. At the same time, the fatigue factor is catching up with them.
Very obvious, that's right. Here's Caguioa, crossover dribble. Abuda staying in front of him, misses the shot, he gets his own miss, goes up again, short. Sinagip ni Crisano, pero may foul na makukuha siya. Laban kay Ildefonso.
Well, I think there's a danger, guys. If San Miguel wins this game, and it's not over yet, Ginebra's going to have to win on Wednesday. I don't think Ginebra can beat San Miguel 4 out of 5 times.
That is a
illegal defense.
Illegal defense, that's right. With that much time remaining in the quarter.
12-point lead here by San Miguel.
A lot of time here, 6:40. In the meantime, Limpot will go to the line. Well, we talked about drama in this series. Of course, San Miguel looking to become the first team to hold all three championship trophies since Alaska's Grand Slam back in 96.
Like Tiger Woods, huh?
That's like Tiger Woods.
That's what I put on the board the night they won. It's a Tiger Slam.
And the last time the Beermen were in an all-Filipino finals was in 1997 under this man right here beside me. Natalo sila doon. Here's Limpot. Wala. Tapik ni Limpot. Wala pa rin. Of course, Limpot playing in his first all-Filipino, or rather, first finals in the PBA in over 350 games.
He's really fatigued. The second jump really wasn't there that time.
Rosella, he has 4 out of 4 now. Make it 5 out of 5. From PLDT IDD long distance shot brought to you by PLDT NDD. Now as low as 3 passes per minute anytime and anywhere in the Philippines. Call 171 for free NDD activation. What a game for him. Caguioa, double in, voila. Rebound in Velasco.
I think Alice got to get their head back into the ballgame soon.
Well, or he'll make a decision here to yank everybody because they're dead tired and just say, okay, first game's over and let's rest. And, I mean, he's got to take a rest on Monday and Tuesday here to prepare.
Look at the performance of Alce Mozella today.
14 in the first half, 20 points in the ballgame, 3 rebounds, perfect from the 3-point territory.
Wow.
He's been honing up on those shots.
Oh, just a magnificent performance today for Rosella.
He's been miserable from the 2-point territory.
Yes. Oh, nice tap there by Magdulis. Velasco's quick to the ball. Loses it, taps it to Rosella. Gets away. Running shot. You know. This may be the last ditch stand now for Brgy Ginebra. Cross court. Magdulis catches it. Goes inside. And a foul.
That was a very inaccurate pass by Jun Lipot. Even if the guy caught it, he would not be free for a shot.
That's correct.
Siegel will pick up his fourth foul now. Siya nga pala, nice kumbatiin lang ng Happy Fiesta, mga taga Dream Homes, de La Paz, Pasig City. Lalong lalo na si Justin Reyes. Happy Fiesta, buddy.
Well, it's the month of May. Fiesta's all over. I understand that Boss Dandin is in Bacolod right now.
That's correct. Yeah.
I wonder who he's rooting for.
That's why he stayed away.
He's rooting for the winner.
Is this a no-lose or a no-win situation?
Well, it could be an all-lose situation also. People have asked me.
But this is just... Well, if you look at the crowd, sizing by the size of the crowd here, this is already a win-win situation for both teams.
I was very surprised that I thought the Ginebra's fans would kind of dominate it. It's quite even.
That's right.
It's not 50-50, but it's pretty close.
Well, right now, San Miguel is dominating on the scoreboard. They're up by 12 here, 72-60. 5 minutes remaining. Siegel.
No solution. No solution to Danny Siegel posting up.
And he's still just taking it easy. Dynamite Danny giving them a 14-point lead now. Limpot cuts loose. Caguioa, Inigot. Calpito bangs. Offensive foul. Well, he had a magnificent first half, but unable to follow it up here in the second.
Well, John also gambled here. He didn't take Ildefonso out in the second half. John wants this game.
Yeah, he wants to get number one. That's true.
He didn't take Ildefonso out.
One thing about John Wichico, in his last 4 championships, in his last 4 trips, he has always won game number one. Velasco, stripped of the ball. Nakuha ni Caguioa. 4.5 remaining here. It's a 14-point lead for San Miguel.
The only problem is Caguioa running by himself. You know, there's nobody on the wing.
Caguioa, wala pa rin.
I haven't seen the Ginebra bench get up one time and say, let's run, let's go, let's go. Yeah. It's just not there tonight.
Well, the energy is not there. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is not, maybe. There's the tap.
It's a good play by Ildefonso.
Whoops. Ball slipping. Ooh, baksak si Magdulis. Here's Siegel. Gives it to Rosella. Pulls the trigger again. And an offensive rebound by Ildefonso.
Go run the clock.
Under 4 minutes to go here. Working on Calpito. Turns. One-handed shot.
Yes.
Game over. Game over.
He never needs a timeout.
And they will call one as the San Miguel Beer fans begin to celebrate with 3:50 remaining. New technology, Motolite. Mas pang matagalan. Only 3:40 remaining in the ball game. Noli yala po kasama si Dr. J, Andy Howe, and Coach Ron Jacobs. Final moments of game number one. Lago. Yes. Lead is down to 12. Colorado 14.
Coach Alan trying something new with the lineup, a smaller lineup, but a speed one. You know, you've got to do some a lot of backcourt pressure, try to steal the ball.
San Miguel breaking that press.
And if they can break the press, you know they're going to use the clock.
That's right. Rosellas had a magnificent start to this series. Aldeponsa as well, and even Siegel together with the rest of the San Miguel beer men. There's Aldeponsa missing. Galpito gets the rebound. Now it's a 14-point lead here with about 3 minutes remaining. Helterbrand. And misses that one. Mananatili sa panig ng Barangay Ginebra. Oh, we take a look at Commissioner's Row. Of course, ang ating paboritong konsyal sa Quezon City, Mr. Ricky Del Rosario, and of course, former Commissioner Leo Prieto.
I think a lot of people owe that man a lot for this league.
Oh, yes, sir.
It was very good, Leo, of course.
Oh, yeah, yes. In the meantime, Jun Limpot cuts down the lead to a dozen. Case of too little, too late here.
Even then, whatever happens, it could be positive for them.
Siegel.
Whoa! That is a no fear slam. Face your fears. Live your dreams. What a move by Siegel. Wow.
Here's Caguioa. Silago. Weave in the perimeter. Helterbrand. Yes. That is a PLDT IDD long distance shot.
Whatever happens, this is positive for Ginebra. These last few minutes.
Especially Lago shooting well.
Lead is down to 11 here. 2:07 remaining. Ginebra still trying. Ooh, banging underneath. Holding foul on Mark Caguioa.
They're in the penalty.
At the start of this game, well, Ron, you talked about how obviously Jun Limpot was tired, and I guess when you look back in this game, you'll have to talk about the intensity as well as the fatigue factor here.
Well, the other thing that San Miguel had more time to prepare also, because I know what John did. Heats up the first 2 days after they won, prepared for Shell, and then after practice of the second day, after he had the whole game plan for Shell, he went back and prepared for Ginebra, so that next day they were totally prepared. Allen didn't have that privilege.
That kind of luxury. Well, that's true. In the meantime, last 2 minutes, I hit senyo ng Tanduay Rum, the number one rum. From the long distance, no. Offensive rebound, wala pa rin. Crisano has it, he goes up, and he gets it. Lead is down to 10 with only a minute and 46 remaining.
It's a bad play by Velasco.
Naipit sa kanto. Siegel, aliyup. Hindi nag-materialize. Ildefonso, double team here. Siegel, faking up against Caguioa, traveling. With a minute and a half to go. At the end of this game, we will be choosing our Viva Mineral Water Best Player of the Game. Abangan niyo po yan. Dr. J, of course, and Ron Jacobs will look at that one. In the meantime, we got about a minute and a half remaining here. Here's Helterbrand. Goes inside. Nilaglag kay Galpito, and the lead is down to 8. The press is on. Rosella gives it to Ildefonso. Cross court, nearly picked off.
That was a dangerous pass.
They should foul Freddie. They should have fouled Freddie.
Ildefonso gets away. He goes up. Challenges. Yes! And that just may be it, Dr. J.
At least you can see the struggle is there now.
Balik sa sampung abante, Helterbrand. Burst of speed, and he gets his 2 points inside.
See the spread court, what happens? And Ginebra can get what they want. There was no spread court.
Long pass to Dynamite Danny. Up against Lago, kicks it out to Abuda, and they will control the tempo.
Nice play by Siegel.
Well, San Miguel is 10-0 in the conference when they limit their opponents to 80 points or less. Today, they will go 11-0 as Ginebra has 73 points on the board. Helterbrand. And that's it. The beer man will take game number one of his best of seven finals for the All-Filipino Conference. And just like the four other championships under John Luis Chico, they will win game number one again, Ron.
I think it's very important to win game one.
On the other hand, Andy, of course, on Barangay Ginebra, knows now that they are in for a war.
Yeah, they're definitely, they're the ones who have to make the adjustments. Maybe they have to put some pressure on the backcourt of San Miguel.
And the adjustments will be made as we end game number one of this best of seven All-Filipino Finals. Nanalo po San Miguel Beermen, 81-75. Of course, the score.